Now, welcome back, everybody. We are at the TD Bank Sports Center. Quinnipiac and Harvard tied at 3 heading to the third period. Sad time here at Quinnipiac. A couple of weeks ago, the former hockey coach here at Quinnipiac, Jim Armstrong, passed away. A couple of his former players, in fact, a couple of Quinnipiac Hall of Famers, Rick Ciardello and Mike Barrett, have joined Bill Mecca to talk about Jim Armstrong. Billy?
Yeah, fellas, it's been a tough 2 weeks for the Quinnipiac hockey family, and we lost one of our own in Jim Armstrong. Ricky, give me some of your, I guess, your great memories about Coach.
Yeah, it was an unbelievable loss, sudden loss for us last week. Coach was just the epitome of he gave everything to everyone else and nothing for himself. And he had such respect from all of us players. To 10 years of players, his wake had to have, 700-800 people there. It was just a tremendous, tremendous showing. And he was a great man that helped build this program, which we're very proud of.
Well, he really did. You know, I mean, I've been with Jim, you know, you go to 1980, and he was the hockey coach, and he was a hockey coach for 14 years. And I know, Mike, you had a special relationship with him.
Well, I was fortunate. I was one of a group of guys that not only played for Jim, but mentored and allowed me to get my start in coaching, along with Billy Vanaris, George Hines. And there's other guys out there like Lou Payne that are all coaching to this day that Jim mentored. We were fortunate to have him as a coach, a friend, and a colleague. And to echo what Rick said, we lost a great man.
Yeah, we really did. And you guys have such a part of what Quinnipiac hockey is now. And, you know, you saw Coach here, and he was at the games. And what would he be thinking, Ricky, tonight? Sitting up there, seeing his family, seeing the jerseys with J.A., what's Coach thinking about tonight?
Well, like I said, he was such a quiet man that gained respect just from his actions, not from being flamboyant. He'd be up there, though, with that smirk on his face. He wouldn't be happy about that third goal, I'll tell you that. But he'd be up there with that little smirk on his face, very, very proud of what he was able to create here.
It was really nice tonight, Mike. You saw so many guys come back, and you know, what he did, he developed men. And you guys are probably two of the best players ever to play at Quinnipiac, but you also two of the nicest guys ever to play at Quinnipiac. He had the ability to let you know that life was more important than hockey, and that's something you're going to really pass on to the next generation.
You know, at the wake, a lot of the guys spoke, and a lot of the guys came back tonight for this. And Jim's daughter spoke also and commented how, you know, we were the second family, and we all knew his family came first, and they really did, but he did. We were his second family, and she said, you know, we were his boys, and we were. We came in as boys, and he turned us into young men. So we have a lot to be thankful for.
Now, what would you say to him now, you know? What could you say if you had one more last chance? I know all of us never get that opportunity to say goodbye to somebody, but if you had a chance, Ricky, what's the last thing you would have said to Jimmy?
Boy, that's tough. I did say when we laid him to rest at the cemetery, I said, Coach, you know, you still got to be there for me. It's very important that he's still in my life, and I don't think there will be a last thing that I'll say to Coach ever, because he's been made that much of a difference in my life.
You talk about in life, you talk about a guy that had an impact. Jim Armstrong had an impact. Thanks for sharing your time with me. Back upstairs, fellas.
Thanks, Billy. Good job. Heading to the third, Quinnipiac.